road users and Westminster seem to think we're exactly the same as cars and that we should pay like cars pay. We don't congest. The cars have blocked it. The buses and the cars block the roundabout. We can't even get around.
Checking, we're outside your door now. I don't know if you want to come and see. We've got some new election material that you might want to use as posters or billboards.
Okay, so nobody's going to come out. I know. Oh well, it's a pity not to see you, but we'll be here for a little bit. So if anyone changes their mind, do come down. Thank you, Giles. Cheers. Bye.
Now the reason we're here today is to ask a very simple question. We want these guys here at Tory party headquarters to explain to us again why we should vote Tory. Because if you see the signs we've got up there, you cannot get more hypocrisy from one political party if they try. The Tory party chairman, Eric Pickles, when he was commenting on the bin tax that was being proposed by a Labour council, promptly announced that any Tory councillor supporting such a stealth tax should be ejected from the Tory party. But what about Danny Shawcliffe? Yeah. They're just using these stealth taxes to raise money to plug the hole in Westminster's finances, a hole that they created through their own ineptness and inability to run what was once the richest and best organised council in Europe. And now they're stealth taxing against what their party told them to do. And what did their party do? Absolutely nothing. Do you trust these people to take over where the other lot have gone before? Well, they can come out. We invite them to come down and explain themselves. You never guess what, they didn't want to. Think that people like Clive, who has to go and set up all the sound systems, can actually join us on a motorbike today. Yeah. Spread the word, guys. We fight on we're fighting even stronger now, and with Westminster convincing everybody else that they're out just to nick money, the tide is slowly turning. You only have to look, I think I made a posting on the forum actually about this, is if you look in the Stage magazine this week, there's an article there by the head of the Society of London Theatres crying and moaning about this new tax that Westminster are going to bring in till midnight. 8 months ago, they sided with Danny Chalkley having to go at us for doing a demo. So let me ask you a simple question. It's an economics one. Who cost them more money? Us doing an hour's worth of driving around the West End on a Monday evening back last April, or £5 an hour until midnight forevermore? Contributing to the forum, it's a great way for us to know how you guys are thinking out there, because the last thing I say is very hard for us. We're working all the time, but you guys aren't seeing that work. So I'm sure a lot of you are saying, well, aren't these guys up to it? I assure you, we are really breaking through now, and there's going to be some major changes coming over the next month. So keep those posts coming. Spread the word to the other bikers. They want this nationally. We're going to stop it right here.
It's been aided incredibly about the exposing by the BBC of how they get to office, I don't know, but the self-serving politicians who've completely screwed up, say one of the wealthiest councils going, are now having to go to the people and steal from them, literally steal from them, what they've never needed to do before, to repair holes in the council's finances. It's incredible.
It's not just the Tories, it's the Labour Party. Both main parties are keeping a distance from this, because actually, if Westminster can get away with this, there will be some of them that will carry on. What I'm hoping is the more principled people in the Tory party will take a fresh look at this and think, hang on a minute, this is a step forward. So I'm not dismayed by the reaction at the moment. I think it's very understandable. It's all about party politics. But in the end, this council is on its own, and I think it's going to stay on its own. Because one of the things that's happened today is every council in this country is going to look at what goes on and try and introduce this sort of attack. They're going to think, we really don't need this, and it's not going to happen.
They're stealing from the people. The people have to fight back. We're fighting back. We're never going away until this tax does. Simple as that.